Hi guys, I'm Rick. Welcome to my kitchen. Today I'm making whole chicken noodle soup. Alright, I'm starting out here with one large onion, two stalks of celery, and two carrots. And I'm going to roughly chop these because these are going to go in my pressure cooker. And they're going to cook down to nothing. So they're just to season our stock. So I'm not worried about getting fancy with them. Okay, now that I have my vegetables chopped up, I have a chicken here. It's roughly 4.5 to 5 pounds. It's been thawing for the past few days. I'm going to go ahead and drop that down into my pressure cooker. And I'm using my 6-quart electric pressure cooker today. Let me give my hands a quick rinse. And I'm going to add some water in here. And I don't know how much juice this chicken is going to put off as it cooks, so I don't want to put a whole lot of water in here. If I need to, I can add more later. Okay, that looks good. Now I'm going to add in those vegetables. And also, I'm adding a bay leaf. Add these down in there. And like I said, these vegetables will cook down to nothing. They're just to season the stock. I'm also going to add in 2 chicken bouillon cubes. I probably don't need them, but I like my chicken extra chickeny flavor, my soup. I'm going to add in some pepper. I'm going to go with about a teaspoon, and I'm going to add in some salt. I'm going to do about a teaspoon of that. Alright, I'm going to seal this up. Alright, I'm going to cook this for 45 minutes on high pressure. So I'm going to go ahead and set my time here. Alright, my chicken's done. I went for the 45 minutes and I did a quick release on it. Now this is going to fall apart when I go to take it out. But that's normal and to be expected. So I'm going to pull all my chicken pieces out. And on this cookie sheet here, I'm going to separate off the meat. I'm going to drain the broth and put it back in and return the meat back into the pot also. Alright, I have all of my meat pulled off of the chicken and returned back in with the stock. Now I'm going to add a little more salt because I tasted this and it needs more salt. I'm going to try a teaspoon. And I'm just using up this kosher salt that I had from a prior recipe. And I'm going to give this a taste now. Excuse me. See if it needs more salt after this. And all them vegetables that were in there, I took them out and got rid of them because they were pretty much beat. I'm going to put another teaspoon of salt in there. And just want to put little bits of the thyme in there and taste as you go. And this broth is tasting really good. A little more salt. Because I really couldn't judge the salt before because the raw chicken was in there. And it wouldn't be a good idea to taste that with raw chicken in there. Alright. A better taste. Just a hair more. If you don't like it as salty, you don't have to put as much salt in. Which this isn't super salty, but I like it seasoned well. Okay, that's good. Alright, I'm also going to add in some cracked pepper in this, just a little bit. And it's coming up to a boil. I have it set for 4 minutes on high pressure. I will close it and let it pressure cook. I'm going to add in some white noodles. Now, this is a 16-ounce package. I'm not going to use all of this. I'm probably going to add in a little less than half. Let me give this a stir. More. Right. And I'm going to finish this off with some frozen spinach. And it's just going to give it color and a little bit of flavor. I'm just going to put in about a handful. And I'm going to seal this up. It'll come up to pressure and cook for 4 minutes. Then my noodles will be done, my spinach will be cooked through, and everything will be ready to go. Alright, my noodles are done, my soup is finished, my broth is nice and golden. Let's go ahead and serve this up and see what we got. Alright, there you have it, whole chicken noodle soup. Give this a try, I think you'll like it, and until next time, I'll see you.